everyone. Welcome to Studio Classroom on the Air. This is the place to come when you want your English to improve. My name is Rebecca, and it's game time. Are you game to play a game? Okay, now that just means, are you ready to play a game? But this isn't any type of game we're talking about. This is Tetris 99, a battle of the blocks. Perhaps you are familiar with the original Tetris game. However, this new version takes Tetris to a whole new level. Today's lesson is titled Tetris 99, a battle of the blocks. And today we are going to find out how this classic puzzle game is being revolutionized. So, revolutionizing a classic puzzle game. And if you revolutionize something, that just means you make it even better. Well, friends, open up your magazines and it's time for us to begin.
Tetris 99, a battle of the blocks. When new games come out, they usually have a tutorial that teaches players the rules. Tetris 99 did not. So the online community created instructions to help one another and to train new players. Players often make videos that teach special strategies and techniques. They also like posting their high scores and showing off their skills. Do you think you could become one of the best Tetris 99 players? A great way to find out is by joining a tournament game.
Well, in this next section, we're going to learn some interesting things about games. We read, when new games come out, they usually have a tutorial that teaches players the rules. Now, this reminds me, Gabe, of a question I would like to ask you. Do you think it's necessary for new games to have tutorials?
Well, first of all, a tutorial, you see that word tutor in there, it's like you're learning something. You're learning the rules in a tutorial. And no, I don't think it's necessary all the time. In fact, a lot of people these days, a lot of young kids who play video games, they don't like tutorials. They don't like that a game might force you to watch a tutorial as you're getting into it. You just want to play the game. But sometimes a game might have a tutorial, a couple of scenes that take a few minutes or longer to teach you how to play or what to do. It could be kind of annoying. I think it should be a choice that you can make.
Ah, well, that's a very, very good point. Perhaps it should be a choice. Now, of course, our lesson is saying that when new games come out, they usually have a tutorial. However, Tetris 99 did not. So the online community created instructions to help one another and to train new players. So maybe they don't have a tutorial of some sort, but they do have people in this community who are creating maybe rules and helping other people learn how to play.
Well, exactly. So Nintendo didn't create one, but I have seen at least one on YouTube, one guy who created a tutorial specifically for Tetris 99 because Nintendo didn't have a tutorial. So you can go check it out too, friends, if you want to learn how to play this game and all the different things that make it special. You can go check out some tutorials online. They are there.
Well, our lesson actually says that. It says players often make videos that teach special strategies and techniques. And I guess some of these videos might also have instructions as to how to play the game.
And I gotta say, I think that's a pretty smart move on Nintendo's part. Like, I think Nintendo is very aware these days of the social media world. And so they want to give power to people who are actually playing to create these things to help the other people. It creates more of a sense of community. You know, it's different than if they just gave all the rules themselves, you know?
Right, and perhaps that's exactly what they had in mind. They were wanting to create a community or encourage a community among the players or the gamers, as people who play a game are often called. Well, we read here, they also like posting their high scores and showing off their skills. And who is they? Of course, that refers to the players. Now let's take a look at those words, showing off or to show off. This is just when someone behaves in such a way that is intended to attract attention or admiration, and sometimes other people may find it rather annoying.
That's right. I guess traditionally this has kind of had a negative connotation or idea with it, but it could be a positive thing. I mean, perhaps you just really wanted to show off your new car or your new bag or your new whatever to your friends. And that could be okay. But if someone does it all the time, there's actually a noun we have for that person. You could say, wow, she's such a show-off, or he is such a show-off.
Yes, and if someone is such a show-off, other people usually find that person to be rather annoying. Now, I personally don't think that there's anything wrong with, you know, showing, if you have, you know, certain skills, mm-hmm. and you've worked really, really, really hard and you're proud of it, why not show it off? But when you do it in a way that's kind of arrogant,
sure,
or you're trying to show that you think you're better than other people, I think it's wrong.
I liked it, you know, when you showed off your new charcoal in your water bottle, because you're talking about how good it is for you and how it could purify your water. So that's showing off in a good way.
That's right. Well, we see a question here. Do you think you could become one of the best Tetris 99 players? Well, a great way to find out is by joining a tournament game.
Well, hey, but you might have the cards stacked against you. You never know.
Well, that's a great phrase. Let's learn more about that in the InfoCloud.
Welcome to today's InfoCloud, friends. Earlier this month, we taught the phrase, pass the buck, which comes from poker. Now, we'd like to share a couple of expressions that also come from games.
When you feel like many factors of a situation are against you, you could say, the cards are stacked against me.
If a player stacks cards in a game, they arrange cards in the deck to be more favorable to them winning.
This is why the expression is to have the cards stack against you, meaning you aren't likely to win.
This phrase also can be used to talk about general bad luck that someone might be having.
The cards are stacked against Irene. She lost her keys and wallet in the same day.
One other common expression is no dice. When gambling with dice was illegal in the U.S., police officers would have to make sure they caught people with their dice and keep them as evidence.
The judge wouldn't be able to convict the gamblers of a crime without the dice. No dice came to mean that something isn't possible.
So, if someone were to ask me, hey, did you get those movie tickets? I could say, no dice. The show is already sold out.
Okay, there we go. We're doing great. Oh, hey, everyone. Welcome back to Studio Classroom. I'm in the middle of a very intense game. I'm playing Tetris 99. I'm hoping to join the Tetris 99 competition. Maybe, just maybe, I'll become one of the best players. Do you think so? I hope so. Let's see. Well, anyway, friends, we have more to learn about Tetris 99, so let's get back to our lesson. And I'm going to continue playing. Let's see, we're doing great. Oh, yes!
Tetris 99. A Battle of the Blocks. This year, Nintendo held its first Tetris 99 tournament, the Tetris 99 Maximus Cup. They invited players from all over the world to participate. The best 999 players were awarded 999 gold points to use in Nintendo's eShop. This was a very competitive event. One person even hired a Tetris expert to coach him for the competition. This game has become very popular. So what are you waiting for? Grab your Nintendo Switch and join the Battle of the Blocks.
Well, earlier we talked about a tournament game or competition, right? We read this year, Nintendo held its first Tetris 99 tournament, the Tetris 99 Maximus Cup. Does that sound like something you're interested in participating in?
No, not me. I like the game, but I don't think I would join the tournament. But we read they invited players from all over the world to participate. That's great. They are trying to get their worldwide community involved in this game.
The best 999 players were awarded 999 gold points to use in Nintendo's eShop. What a great award. You get tokens to use in an eShop.
It is. It's true. And you can buy a lot of stuff in the Nintendo eShop that you might be able to use for other games. Well, we read this was a very competitive event. Of course it was. You know, I have known some pretty competitive Tetris players growing up in Qingshui. Sometimes, or in Taizong, like you go outside of a store and there's like one of those arcade machines. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it would be Tetris. And so I would see people, young guys or girls, and there's two of them playing against each other. And they were really, really good. Some people are really competitive with Tetris.
Well, speaking of competitive, our lesson says one person even hired a Tetris expert to coach him for the competition. I think this guy was probably pretty competitive. This game has become very popular. So, what are you waiting for? Okay, before we continue, let's talk about this question. This is just a fun way of saying, let's do it. You don't need to wait anymore. Just go do it.
Exactly. It's what we would call a rhetorical question. That means you kind of already know the answer. What are we waiting for? Or what are you waiting for? Of course, you shouldn't wait for anything. Just go do it. So what are we waiting for? Let's go to the next sentence here. Grab your Nintendo Switch and join the Battle of the Blocks. Grab. Well, Rebecca, do you have a Nintendo Switch?
No, actually, I do not have a Nintendo Switch.
You've been borrowing mine.
I've been borrowing yours. I've been having fun pretending that I was really, really good at Tetris, or Tetris 99. I actually am really good at Tetris. Like the classic game Tetris. I've never played Tetris 99, but who knows? I might be really good.
Well, playing against 98 other people certainly would add a challenge. But let's take a look at that word grab. What does that mean in our lesson?
Now, this doesn't mean that you literally grab something from someone. It just means that you quickly get something.
Yeah, often we use this to talk about maybe if you don't have time to eat somewhere, you don't have time to sit down and enjoy a meal, you might just need to grab something from somewhere. I'm going to grab a sandwich from 7-Eleven, and then I have to go off in a hurry.
Right. Now, we've been talking about Nintendo competitions. Gabe, how do you feel about Nintendo competitions?
Well, I think competitions of all kinds are great, and it's smart for companies like this to have competitions because it gets more people involved in their products, right? I remember when I was younger, when Donkey Kong first came out for Super Nintendo, I was in Colorado, and my cousins got involved in a Donkey Kong competition.
Well, now that sounds like fun.
It's great.
It is so great. Well, friends, what do you think about Nintendo competitions? Talk about that in English, and let's watch a review skit.
Whoa! An old classic gets new life.
I prefer the new games.
Come on, get out of here. Hey, man, well, why throw something away if you can change it and make it cool again?
Cool again? Really?
Yeah! Tetris 99 is a fantastic example.
Tetris 99. You know, I played the original Tetris. It was a simple and fun game to play. Just move the blocks around to make them fit, clear a line, and hooray!
Yeah. And Tetris 99 takes that formula a step further by making it a high-speed multiplayer experience.
Wait, multiplayer?
Yeah. Check it out.
Yeah. What do you mean? Okay, wait, so in this game, you play against, how many, 98 other players
yeah,
at the same time?
Yes, 98 plus you equals Tetris 99.
Yes, I just cleared a line and got some points.
Oh, and sent obstacles onto my screen. Well, watch out. I just sent obstacles onto your screen, so there.
Hey, the music just changed, and the blocks are falling more quickly.
That's because other players are defeated. Oh, this is getting exciting.
And very intense. Oh, I'm out.
Me too. Game over for me and you. But look, the others are still playing.
You know what? It's kind of fun. I'm going to look up the rules on the tutorial.
Sorry, this game came out without a tutorial. But don't worry, the online community created instructions to help train new players.
Must be a great community of players.
It is. Players often make videos that teach special strategies and techniques.
Oh, hey, I see. They also like posting their high scores and showing off their skills.
Mm-hmm.
But I bet I can become one of the best players.
Well, you can find out by joining a tournament game. People from all over the world participate.
Hmm. I might want to do that. And maybe I'll win.
Oh, yeah? Maybe I'll win.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm going to hire a Tetris 99 coach.
Yeah, well, maybe I am a coach.
Oh.
Well, anyway, what are you waiting for? Grab your Nintendo Switch and join the Battle of the Blocks.
All right.
Want to go again?
Let's get in again.
Let's get in this.
Okay. All right, I'm in.
You're in? I'm in. Mm-hmm. I'm in.
Oh, hey, everyone. The Tetris 99 competition is almost here. And I've decided that I need to hire my own personal coach because I want to compete in this competition. What about you all? Are you ready for a little competition? Well, what are you waiting for? Go grab your Nintendo Switch and see if you're ready to compete. Well, friends, thank you so much for joining us today. We'll see you next time right here on Studio Classroom.